I'm Ellen McCauley, and we're at Pray It Off in Syracuse, New York. Now, we're in the third week of Lent, maybe the second, end of the second, beginning of the third week of Lent. And I want to say something about Lent every week. And I think this article was in the Catholic Sun. And I read the Catholic Sun like I read the church bulletin from cover to cover. I love the Catholic Sun. And this was an article called Journey to the Foot of the Cross, 10 Things to Remember for Lent. And it is so powerful. I loved this article. You know, the formula for Lent, prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. That's the formula. Pray more, eat less, help other people. First of all, it's a time for prayer. Do you have a ritual for your prayer? I told you all that I start my day with these prayer books, with these prayers. I love it. I'm getting so much out of it. And it's a time to fast. And fasting's actually a form of penance, which helps us turn away from sin towards Christ. And fasting can be a number of things. You know, I'm not telling you to have nothing but water all day. You can fast from pizza. You can fast from cookies. You can fast from Honker bread. You can just fast from some of these things. And one of the things that you can do is, and it said it in one of my books this morning, let's say we're concerned about Ginny, who's in the hospital, and we're tempted with some cookies. And you say, Lord Jesus, I'm going to fast from these cookies as a special intention for my friend Ginny in the hospital. I offer that for her. When we offer our fasting or our sacrifices for someone else, God likes it, because we're thinking about other people, and we're hitting two with one. We're fasting and we're giving. Think about dying to yourself, finding those aspects of yourself that are less than Christ-like and letting them die. Letting them die. And you know, last week we talked about drama. And Sunday, you know, our son Vincent was a freshman at NYU. He called and he had a very serious problem at college, a problem that resulted in some financial debt, some money, a problem. And he called me. We had a very calm, logical discussion where we talked about responsibility. We talked about learning. We talked about going forward. And as his mother, I said, of course, your father and I will help with this problem. And we went forward, no drama whatsoever. My stomach wasn't in knots. I didn't internalize it. I figure, you know, we can get, you know, it's a few $100. We can come up with that. And then no drama, proud of myself. And then I worked on Pray It Off all day. Monday morning, I got up, went to my computer, dead. Deader than a doornail. And I was like, well, what up? Checked the plug, went to work, got my lunch, Googled a few fixes, got home, nothing worked. You have to know me like my husband knows me, because when there's something wrong with my computer, it used to throw me in a total tailspin. And now here I am with everything I own, all my Pray It Off records, the logs, the list, the everything, Pray It Off is on the computer. Now I backed it up back in October, so I don't have anything from the final months. There's a shop right across from Fairmount Fair called Dart Computer. I want to recommend him to everyone. He is awesome. But you can't fix it. It's dead. He said he saw 12 of these in the past few months. It's 7 years old, seven years old. They just die. So we're going to go get a new computer. I'm telling my 81-year-old mother on Monday about my problems. My computer's dead. You know, we had a problem with some money for NYU. And she's like, listen. Now, this is a woman who's got her heat at 61 because she doesn't want to pay the National Grid any more than she has to. She says, listen, I've got enough money to bury me and your sister. I'll give you some money for your computer and to help you out there. I just wanted to stop, because here's this woman who clips coupons and has the heat at 61. But she's my mother. I had a problem. Vince had a problem. I'm his mother. And isn't it all about the love? When you reduce drama down to the love, and I didn't overreact to the computer. I didn't overreact to the money, because I'm trying to learn the lessons to try to be more Christ-like, and things will work out. Number six, don't do too much. How many times do we say, I want to weigh 120 and exercise 5 hours a day and have be so Christ-like that they beatify me in my lifetime? And then we don't do it the next day and we give up on all of it. Keep it simple, stupid. KISS, the KISS method. You know, some people are not doing so good at the scale, and I said, well, what are you doing for Lent? They're like, nothing. No, we're in this group, and you're doing nothing for Lent. I want to smile them. Come on, do something. Eat less, move more, pray, do something. We spend our entire lives growing closer to God. Don't try to cram it all into one Lent. That's a recipe for failure. We spend our entire lives growing closer to our goal weight. We're not going to do it in one session. We just have to try to be healthy. Lent reminds us of our weakness. I don't know about you guys, but I'm kind of weak. Through Christ, I am stronger. God wants us to seek his help with renewed urgency and sincerity. And remember I told you one of my goals was peace. Peace. That a lot of these things we're talking about, giving us peace. And I said to God the other day, I said, God, why do I always feel on edge? Why do I always feel that life is a battle? And then I felt an answer. I felt like, because it is. Life is a battle. We are battling the forces of this world, which is evil, which is Satan. We'll name it. We'll look like the church lady in Saturday Night Live. It's Satan. That's it. But we're in a battle. And we can either give in to the drama of that battle, or we can gird ourselves with the armor and the shield of Christ and say, I'm going to find some peace behind this armor because I can't do it. I'm weak. Reach out in charity. Reach out and help those. You know, one of the books I'm reading, and you might say, you keep saying one of the books. I'm reading like seven. I'm like, this one, that one. I love it. One of the books I'm reading, she's like, I always felt I was giving because I'd write out my check. Oh, something in Haiti? There's my check. I did it. But when you give of your time, when you give of your guts and your spirit and something, when you go to you can either go to France's house and sit there holding the hand of someone who's leaving this earth, or make a meal, or sit with a family, or you can write France's house a check. Both are meaningful. Both are needed. And you might say, Ellen, I can barely survive as it is. I can't find that time. Well, you can find time then to turn away the pizza for someone at Francis' house. See, give, take. Learn to love like Christ. I really, when my mother told me about, I love how she said, I got enough money to bury me. I got some extra money. I'll give it to you, honey. And then I was having a money fight with her. Absolutely not, Mom. No, no, no. No, I'm giving it to you. I don't care if you want it or not. I'm giving it to you. You buy a computer. Buy a good one. Buy one that won't die on you. I said, well, I did have it for 7 years, Mom. And she goes, you'd think it'd still be good. But it's like phones. People don't have phones for 7 years anymore. They have phones for a year or 2 years, the computer. So the thing is, I felt the love. I felt the love of Christ because that's what's in the family. Loving like Christ, who suffered and poured himself out unconditionally on the cross for all of us. Lent is a journey through the desert to the foot of the cross on Good Friday. As we seek him out, ask for his help, join in his suffering, and learn to love like him. I have one word. Wow. I'm going to stop right there, Father.